Hello, my friend. I remember when you were so alive with your white eyes to the light that you had and your heart was stolen. Now you say that it ain't worth staying. You wanna run, but you're hesitating. I'm talking.
Welcome to our e-learning daily practice mathematics by Nelson Wanyama. Yeah, previously we were looking at construction of some basic angles. We did not exhaust all of them. That will be in our next lesson, but we wanted to put the angles we have learned, some of them in perspective, by constructing some polygons. And now we are beginning with a regular polygon, and that's a rhombus, a four-sided polygon. You know, the brief history of it is that the beauty of it that it has all sides equal, and the best angles, all of them, I must say that the best angles add up to 180, the two best angles and the upper angles. The other thing also we need to know about is that diagonally opposite angles of a rhombus are equal. And most importantly, that diagonals intersect at a right angle, diagonals of a rhombus. So, we shall construct a rhombus, and this is our question now. Let's look at the question and we see how we appreciate the angles we learned and how we can apply them in construction of a rhombus. So the question says, using a pair of compasses, a ruler and a pencil only, construct a rhombus EFGH of side 6 cm, where angle EFG is equal to 120 degrees, and drop a perpendicular bisector from point G to meet line EF at K. So, step number one, when we are to construct our rhombus, is to begin with a sketch there. So we shall have our sketch diagram. Our sketch. And on our sketch, we have E, F, G, H. We are constructing a rhombus E, F, G, H. Now this one helps us to understand that we can make E, F, as our base line and GH as our upper line. The other thing we need to know also that they have given us that now because EF is our base line and we already have angle F because it is angle EFG and F owns 120 degrees. So angle F is 120 degrees. And on our baseline, we have EF. The base angles, the two base angles of our rhombus add up to 180 degrees. Because those angles are co-interior angles. And co-interior angles add up to 180 degrees. So because we already have angle F, which is 120 degrees, we now need angle E, which will help us. And angle E, we shall get it by getting 180 degrees minus 120 degrees. That means that angle E is equal to 60 degrees. So if angle E is 60 degrees and angle F is 120 degrees, the two angles qualify to be co-interior angles because they add up to 180 degrees. Now, having known that, we need to also know that our rhombus, all sides are equal. So every side is 6 centimeters, meaning side line E F is equal to 6 centimeters and all sides
are 6 centimeters. They are the same.
So we shall draw our sketch now. We draw a sketch, diagram. Now, this beginning with that line, this will be E and this will be F. EF is 6 centimeters. But remember, we are constructing a rhombus EFG. That means EFG, G somewhere, and the angle F is 120 degrees. And the stomach of an obtuse angle, this is how the stomach of an obtuse angle looks like. Now, because F is an obtuse angle, of course, now E is an acute angle. And this is how we draw the stomach of an obtuse and an acute angle. So here, E is 60 degrees and the angle F is 120 degrees. So we shall come up with our beautiful sketch where we have EFG, EFG and H. So our sketch. So a rhombus sketch. And the other thing we also need to know that now, because of this sketch, we must put the properties of a rhombus, that opposite sides are parallel to each other. Line EF and HG and line HG, and put our G up there. Line EF and line HG are parallel to each other, and also line EH is parallel to line FG, but all sides are equal. And they are 6 centimeters. That is our sketch. The moment you finish our sketch, we are ready to have our actual diagram. We are going to drop a perpendicular bisector from G to meet line EF at K. So I will prolong the line. I am predicting the eventualities. That's why I'm drawing. Beginning with a longer line. A longer line. And after that, now, I will have my starting point, and this will be point E, where I must construct 60 degrees. But before that, I have to measure from E, this is point E, to F. I must measure 6 centimeters on my ruler. So it means I'll get my ruler here. I'll get the ruler, get the compass, and measure from 0 centimeter, from 0, from where we start from, up to 6 centimeters. After measuring up to 6 centimeters, then I'll come here and make an arc. Make an arc. So that arc, this arc, the arc here is for point F. Now, EF is 6 centimeters. So I have to label 6 centimeters. After having 6 centimeters, I now construct 60 degrees at point E, from where we started from, angle E. So remember how we were constructing 60, we constructed 60 degrees, put there, and I make an arc. The same radius, I put my compass here, and make another arc such that they intersect. Now, having done that, you the same approach. Just bring at point F in the same radius and do the same. When you do the same thing, you'll find that 60 will be outside, but 120 will be inside at point F. So here I wanted 60 and 60 is inside, but here with the same approach, the way we did it, do the same at point F, and you will end up getting 120 inside. The same approach I've done like this and here. So from there, you get your ruler and join. Remember here, we are joining at point E to get our angle of 60 degrees. So we first check this point and this. Then we draw our line. After drawing, do the same here. So when you draw the line here, like I said, 60 will be outside, but the angle, the opposite angle of 60 is 120, which we want at point F. So you check here and here. Then we are able to draw the line. So having done that, you name this angle E inside is 60 degrees. And angle F inside is 120 degrees. In a polygon, do not name angles outside. We name angles inside the polygon. Having done that, now, remember we're constructing a rhombus, E, F, G, H. So from E, F, we go to, from E, F, we go to G. G is up. And it is 6 centimeters. That means I need my 6 centimeters here and this. Such that I put here, on the same radius, I make an arc up there. The same radius I put here of 6 centimeters and I make another arc up such that I get my upper points, and that is G and H. Having done that, then you draw. You join to form your rhombus properly. But before you join, please check whether your line will pass at the exact points of need. Good. So, this is point G. This one is point G. And this very point, this one, is point H. Now, don't forget to put properties. Opposite sides are parallel to each other. And this one also is parallel. Here I put double, here I put single to differentiate the sides. Then this property is that all sides are equal. Now this is our rhombus, E, F, G, H. Where angle E, F, G is 120 degrees. This angle is very important. Angle F, where I see F, it must be 120 degrees. That's the checkpoint. And of course, if this is F, then the other base angle again must be 60 degrees because both angles are co-interior. Like I said in the other properties, the opposite diagonal opposite angles are equal. This will be 60 degrees, this will also be 120 degrees. But as for now, that is our hexagon. Sorry, that is, as for now, that is our rhombus. But we are not yet finished. The question continues and says, draw a perpendicular bisector from point G to meet line F. Draw a perpendicular bisector from point G to meet line F at K. So we are beginning from point G to draw our perpendicular bisector. And how do we draw our perpendicular bisector? We first get the perpendicular curve. Stand at point G, then get a perpendicular curve. The curve on this line. That's why this was very important to prolong this line at at the beginning, because we're predicting the extension of the line, but already we extended it. We had it in abundance. So I stand at point, my compass at point G, and get the perpendicular curve. The perpendicular curve from here, and I get a perpendicular curve which must intersect our line. So from here like this, it must intersect the line like that. The key point is where this curve meets the line, this point here and this one. Two important points. And after getting those points now, we can reduce and adjust the radius. Adjust the radius of our compass, put here, adjust again. You make an arc there, same radius, you put here, and you make another arc. Wonderful. After making that arc, we therefore now need this point where the two arcs have met to connect up to point G. Now from G, we go first line EF and we meet, go so past this point where the two arcs have met. So we draw our line, drop our perpendicular here like this, continue down. So that is drawing a perpendicular line, but it must meet line EF at point, must meet. This is where now it meets line EF. This point is where we call point K. Now you can be asked to measure line GK. When you're measuring line GK, please measure from here up to here. Don't go beyond, because where we need, where it meets line EF, that's the point where K is. We shall have finished to construct our rhombus. Thank you so much for learning. I hope you have enjoyed. Stay tuned. And please don't forget to go on our YouTube page. Put in 1L Poling. You will see this video. Like the page. Subscribe. You can share it. You can download it. And enjoy it. Thank you so much. A big thanks to Review Media, Isaac, for a great job. And Mr. Mike. Stay tuned. Keep enjoying our e-learning. Thank you.